right, so we are starting now. So there would be a recording of this session which will be published on our LinkedIn pages. All right, so let's try to keep this entire conversation very interactive, and obviously you cannot speak from the other end, but you can do raise the hand whenever I ask something. And once the discussion, I'm done with my webinar, then we'll try to, I'll bring the questions on, and then we'll try to have that answers in the due course of time. All right, so my first question, which I really want to start with, is that how many of us are feeling bored at home, sitting at home right now? Just raise the hands. Okay, so almost 50% have raised their hands. How many of us are feeling that you don't have any work to do right now? Or you're kind of confused as to what exactly you can do in this period? Okay, only 4 or 5 people have raised their hands. Seems that most of you are engaged. That's great. Okay, so coming to the webinar, we'll try to keep it short and to the point. So I'm basically going to discuss really 4 things which are there in my agenda. The first thing is upskilling in the times of coronavirus or COVID-19 or in any crisis time. The second thing is approaching new jobs or internships, both full-time or part-time. The third thing is how do you really create a rapport with your immediate supervisor if you're already working in an organization, whether it's an internship or it's a virtual internship or it's a job which you have recently entered. And the last bit is that understanding the HR's perception and how they are seeing the scenario and how they see the candidates in at this point of time and how it is different from normal times. Let's just say 1 month back, what is the perception which has changed? So these are the 4 things which we are going to really discuss on. People having any questions can directly put in the Q&A tab. I'm just repeating that. And it would be answered at the end of this webinar. It would last around 15-20 minutes. Okay, so when I say upskilling, upskilling is something which is very, very critical today. So everyone has heard about multitasking. Multitasking is something which is a prerequisite for any job you're entering into or even for internship. Because today organizations are looking for people who can really go beyond their duties which have been assigned by the organization, which actually adds to your how much value you're adding to the organization. So how can you do that? In today's era, there are so many e-learning courses which are there. I would just give certain lists and which I personally feel and are very good. And also I'll give a couple of examples as to, for example, someone who's going in an HR internship or doing an HR job, what they can really do in this period. So there's something called as Udemy. Everyone has heard of Udemy, I think. There's something called as Udacity, which is pretty much similar to Udemy. Again, it's a Silicon Valley born startup. There's something called as EdX. So they have also collaborated with Harvard. And there's another skill development things which are called as Skillshare, which I really recommend because it's very basic. However, it also helps you enhance your skills. At the same time, another product which is there is called as the Coursera, which we have heard of. There is another Indian startup which is doing very good at this point of time, but at least for working professionals. It's a multi-million funded startup. It's called as the Upgrad. Now, Upgrad is offering multiple online courses within which they have collaborated with various universities in India and across the globe. So I think that is another place which you can explore in terms of doing any short-term courses or even online MBAs, which is a latest trend which is happening in the education technology sector. So that is something which you can really see. Another important thing apart from all these platforms would be that so try to learn something new which can really add value to how your profile is today. So when I typically see a candidate who, let's say, is applying for an HR and an opening HR role for like someone who's a fresher, now I would also be interested in a person as to how creative that person can really become in solving the day-to-day challenges. How can he or she bring in different aspects of life? For example, I would recommend that do read about design thinking, because this is something which is already happening and a big future lies in that, in human resources at least. If I have to be very specific, design thinking and employee experience are going to be going hand in hand together, and you should read about the courses. Heads Up's blog would be released very soon on design thinking and employee experience. You can also see there. So when I say design thinking, today organizations are trying to give all the kind of benefits which are possible. At least the startups are trying to do that. However, still there's a huge attrition rate in the Indian startup ecosystem. Organizations which a lot of us perceive to be great have got $1 billion funding. Still people are leaving. You see example of Oyo, they've already laid off more than 4,000 people. You see example of Byju's, where the attrition rate, despite the organization being valued at $8 billion, is huge. So what exactly is not happening is something which people are not able to really relate themselves to the organization. So it all comes down to a step ahead of employee engagement, because we typically hear about employee engagement survey, but I think that has become history in today's organizations. And it has all come down to how we, like as an employer, we can give something which is an experience which people really talk about. The idea is not to just retain the people, but also to make them the brand advocate. So something like this is what we would be looking at. If I am taking an interview of someone for an HR position, I'm looking for someone who can bring such aspects happening around HR, not just the core HR things, what we have read in organization behavior, or we read in leadership or typical recruitment selection. I think everyone is doing that. So what is that extra bit which you are trying to bring in? So that is something which is very critical. So make your own forte. At the same time, make sure that it is aligned with whatever your profile is. So for example, I tend to see a lot of CVs which have got a lot of extracurricular activities. Now, good thing for you guys would be that how you can link your extracurricular activities with the job which you applied for, which we will be talking a little later. My second thing is about how do we really approach any new job or an internship, or whether it's virtual or physically you have to be present. The first and very important thing which lot of job seekers fail to do is they are not able to target how to go about jobs. So they go to a Naukri platform or an iimjobs platform or internshala, and they'll just tap without even understanding the organization, the position, and just seeing ki kahin se response aa jaye. Now this is something which is not a very smart step. Honestly, it's a waste of time, because whenever someone would be calling from the organization, you would really not remember it, let alone the work the organization is doing. And in today's time, when we are already entering into a lot of crisis, we are already in crisis. As an employer, I can easily say that. So it would be very important that you are super selective when you are actually taking up any internship, and very, very, very sure of why you want to do that internship, because these are few questions which any recruiter would be asking. So please be very, very thorough about the organization and the job which you are applying for. The second thing is, so whenever you are doing any research about the organization, it's always good to network, honestly. LinkedIn has just helped the cause, and people easily add you as a friend. You can easily drop in a note, which is there as an option when you are sending a friend request. Please add people from the organization which you are really targeting, and do talk to them. My experience has been that people do respond if you are trying to be very honestly asking about things, and because everyone loves initiative, honestly, in today's world. If you're not taking initiatives, you are already behind in the race. So that is something which we have to make sure that you guys are doing. Specifically for freshers, if I have to say, I can see that there are people who are freshers in here. It's never easy when you are looking for a job, and when you are a fresher looking for a job, it's very difficult. I can understand that, but I think it's also a blessing in disguise. Honestly, my simple suggestion would be for all the first-time job seekers that be very thorough with one subject of your choice. Now, let's say if you're studying human resources, be very thorough with one subject, whether it's OB, leadership, whether it's talent management, whether it's learning or development. Because what happens is that you end up saying in the interview without even understanding as to what the person is asking for. That is a normal trend which I see. So be very thorough with one subject and say this thing and have belief in yourself. If you're not believing in yourself, you are already rejected. The person is just stretching or wasting his time, honestly. So be very thorough as to which subject you are going to say in the interview, and try to read basic stuff, yeah, because no one really remembers. Someone who's taking an interview doesn't really remember stuff who or she is going to ask. So whatever he asks, it would be more basic rather than very advanced. So be very thorough with one subject, and I'm sure you would be in a position to crack the interview. In case you fail to crack the interview, do seek constructive feedback. Honestly, most of the organization which we have seen, clients which we work with, very limited organization, like 1 out of 10, 1 out of even 50, would actually be giving a feedback form to a candidate and seeking their feedback to improve their processes. It really doesn't happen in our country. But a good step can be that you create your own form and just give it to the recruiter, that it would be great if you can give me the feedback. Because if you are able to generate that feedback today, it is going to help you very soon in the next job or in any other interview which you will be going. So always seek very constructive feedback. It's going to be very helpful. The third part of this webinar is about how do you really build rapport. Now, if you're going in any organization for the first time, everything is new, right? You cannot expect things to be very easy. You cannot expect things to be going according to your way. So it's important that you build a relationship. You show your interpersonal skills as to how you are approaching the things. Try to bring in as many stakeholders as possible in whatever you are trying to do, and make them aware on a constant basis that this is what you are doing, this is where you have learned this thing, or you've got stuck. Seek questions, ask questions. Honestly, whenever you are in a first-time job or whether you're in any internship, people are not expecting you to do some rocket science stuff. No, they're not. They are very focused on, is the person believing in himself, and is the person able to do basic work with competency? So that is something which is very important. How do you really make your interpersonal skills? I can assume that there's a high chance that a lot of internships can be virtual at this period of time because of obvious reasons. So there's a big issue of biasness which typically comes in Indian managers as to when they're not able to see people, they feel that they're not able to track them. So I think a good way to go about this thing is that you constantly do an updation of your task. A simple Excel mentioning about the work which you have done in the day, what are the key learnings, and a basic remark which you seek from the manager can be a good way to go forward. That is something which we typically do at HR. So that is another thing which you need to really build. My last bit is about how is the HR world or the HR managers or the recruitment consultants really making the perception, like what is their perception of this entire thing. Now there are a couple of things which are very clear, is that in the last 2 weeks itself, industries like hospitality, travel, like Make My Trip, Go Ibibo, Travel Triangle, OYO, they have been firing left, right and center. What is happening right now, and for which we have, I would also like to mention that whenever you go to our website, which is headsupcorporation.com, you see a new tab which is there, which is a crowdsourced way of generating CVs on the platform. Now it's a free platform where people can, whoever are job seekers, can put in their request or can submit the application. And typically we, at the back end, we are pushing mails, messages, LinkedIn messages from our network to various recruiters and various clients where they can come and start evaluating candidates, because it's a free platform. So that is one thing which you can check. Now coming back to this thing, whenever I say about perception building, people are more interested in firing right now than hiring, honestly. That is a harsh reality, but we cannot ignore that. So whenever you are approaching right now, the HR manager already will be having a lot of resumes compared to any time, which is the normal time, if we have to say. Because what is happening right now is that a lot of organizations are cutting slack. So when organizations are cutting slack right now, there would be a huge pool of candidates applying for jobs. At least you can easily imagine 3x, 4x more candidates applying to any typical job which would be, which is there in the market. Now in that, you need to be very creative. So when I say creative, a lot of organizations have started doing case study interviews, or they try to be this, they tend to see how punctual you are, how open you are to the job. Now please be very sure that you are looking for a new job. Just don't, for the heck of it, just don't go and apply on any job, because if you do, there's going to be a very negative aspect to you, and already HR managers are very like they are in a lot of pressure anyway, because they have to manage the entire firing agenda from the management, and then they also have to make sure that they're not losing out on the talent. So don't become pain for HR managers. Try to make whatever applications you are to the point, very basic. And if you are able to do that, I'm sure you have already crossed more than 50-60% of the applicants who are out there in the market. Because in times of uncertainty, there is a normal psychological thing which also happens, that what when interview hoga, interview nahi hoga, acha Skype pe kare hoga. So we are very customized with the physical aspect, that we have to go to the office, interview dena hai, then we have to see selection hoga, nahi hoga. But be very flexible and in this time, because if flexibility is not there, you are already behind in the curve. So try to be that. And so whenever, let's say you are doing any negotiation in any kind of job or any kind of job in this next 3 months, never say a no for additional responsibilities, because what is going to happen right now is that there's going to be a lot of duplication of job roles in terms of any position. Like so if there's a BD, business development client facing person who is there, he or she would also be supposed to do the BD ops back and work also, because if he or she says a no, then there are people who are standing in the queue to join the job. So try to understand that right now is not a time to say a lot of no. Your comfort zone is definitely not something which the management would be appreciating, because they're already under very, very much pressure in self. So that is something which you have to really be very sure as to, whenever you are applying, be thorough of how the work is there, and never say a no for response. These were certain things which I really wanted to talk about in today's webinar. Now, if there is any other particular topic, I can take a couple of topics to be discussed. So if you can just leave it in the chat here, or which you personally feel, any of the attendees personally feel, else we'll just shift to the Q&A which is there. I have received around 5 questions right now, till now. Someone has asked me industries with most layoffs. Okay, so I am not very sure about the industries with most layoffs. However, I am just sharing a link on the chat message, which is a crowdsourced link of what is the trend which is going on in different industries. Do have a look. I cannot see the name, so it's anonymous. I've shared the link in the chat. Okay. There's another question, that how HeadsUp is dealing with the current situation. Any initiative taken by your startup? So how HeadsUp is dealing? First thing is that HeadsUp is trying to make things very normal, like any other day's affair. So that is the first thing. Which we personally feel is important in any crisis scenario. We are not going apart from, we are not putting extra pressure on our employees, rather than not making them feel any fear that they'll lose their job or something like that, until unless the person has really not really worked in the last quarter, so we cannot do it. But that's not the case. But we are also, we have created the portal which I've already mentioned. Do have a look on that. Just a free platform which we have created. So do have a look on that. If there's anything specific for about HeadsUp you can ask, then do mention it. Okay, so Karthik has asked me that he's pursuing HR from NDIM. That as a fresher, from where we should start adopting knowledge of HR tech. Now, Karthik, the first thing which is there is HR tech in itself is a huge domain. You need to understand as to which part of HR tech you want to tackle to. Are you mentioning about the HR analytics part, or you are looking for interventions into the traditional HR systems, or you are really looking for just basic knowledge about HR tech? My personal suggestion would be that there's a platform which is called as AIHR, which I personally recommend to a lot of people who are looking for HR tech knowledge. Do visit that. I am again mentioning that thing in the chat here. They have got huge repository of resources and things which you can easily study and grasp. It's a very basic language. They also have got courses, by the way, which you can see in different aspects of human resources. I hope that answers your question. Thank you. So Garima has asked me, can you please explain more about design thinking? So design thinking is another, it's a huge thing in itself, and I would expect to have another webinar on design thinking. But just to give you a gist about it, so design thinking, just imagine a time. So everyone has taken a flight, right? Yeah, just raise your hands if someone who has not taken a flight. Okay, everyone has taken a flight. Now, when you are taking a flight, there's a time which is there between when you have supposed to reach to the airport and when you start packing your stuff. And that time gap is around 2 to 3 hours. Now, subconsciously, that is a time which is not very comfortable time, because you're always at the back of your mind ki flight chhoot nahi jayegi, I have to go to and make sure the flight is there. And there is no organization in like Indigo or Go or Spicer who are really there doing anything to improve our experience. So a simple step about design thinking can be that if they are able to create a simple app which basically gives you the live updates as to what is the time the flight is there, or how far you are from the airport. Now, obviously, you can use Google Maps, but when you reach to the airport, reaching to the right gate is something which you tend to miss out, and you get you tend to see people ki kon kidhar ja raha hai, and you finally see the board ki we have to find the gate. But let's say there's an app which is there, which basically becomes a Google map for inside an airport. Now that is where what you're doing is that from your existing resources, you are just putting in a simple request, you're just putting in a simple data in a very structured manner. Now, another example which I think a lot of people could relate here would be, if you have heard about COVIDvisualizer.com, it's a red globe which shows, I can see around 6-7 people raising their hands. Okay, great. So COVID Visualizer is a great example of design thinking, honestly. Because agar aapko main PDF pakda deta hun, all the people who are there, you will not be reading it, honestly. Honestly, what you would be doing is that you are looking for something which is user experience wise very rich, which the platform COVID Visualizer is doing. However, the data which is there, if you go in their website and read about more information, they've actually taking the data, which for that they've given the credit, from another platform which is doing the hard work on the back end, called as a Worldometer. Now, Worldometer is a platform which is actually gathering the data. They are the one which is just showing the interface. So that is where they have used the principle of design thinking in making the public aware as to how many cases of coronavirus is happening. I hope you get a little idea about this. Okay. The next question is that we have heard that interviews should be documented as it's finished so that we have detail on what has been discussed, because there's a lot of interviews on tape that might lead to ethically appropriate would have been impacted. I'm sorry, I'm not, there's no name in this, but can you make sure that be very specific about the question? If you could just reframe your question, please. So there's another question which is there. What is the next step after the lockdown gets over for summer internships? I am not very sure. I'm very clear with the question. Can you just reframe the question? Ashutosh has asked me, please tell me something about Art Milan. Ashutosh, we would be having another webinar very soon about our other verticals for Heads Up, which is there. For Art Milan, if I have to be very in a layman's term, Art Milan is a platform where we are trying to make a marketplace for upcoming designers, upcoming artists, and making sure that their products is visible through our platform to different kind of users. The website is still under construction. It's a new website which we are creating. People are working on that, and we would soon be launching it. You can drop in a LinkedIn message and we will connect you to the right person from our team. Thank you. Okay, so Rizul has asked me what are the KPIs we are looking at in times like this. This is another question. What are the KPIs we are looking at in time like this for evaluating HRs? Which I have already mentioned a lot of things in my webinar. We would also be giving you the recording of the webinar. You can go through that. If there is anything specific, do ask me. Thank you. Shivam has asked me that body language during the interview process really a significant element in assessing the candidate's confidence in other dimensions. Nowadays in coronavirus, when many businesses go online to perform interviews, how can the dimensions be seen and checked? Shivam, there's a big checklist which is honestly there, which we are again going to publish on HR on our blog on Heads Up Corporation's website. Keep a tab on that. Through that blog, we are just trying to create a checklist of what are the things which you need to have or what are the things which you have to do while you are going for any online interview. My couple of things which are there which for online interview which I will suggest is, first, you you be right there on time, because most of the people who are taking interviews, they have got back-to-back slots, so it's not a physical thing jahan pe ho jata hai chal jata hai, attitude works. In this online space, people have got their laptop, they have just switch on a couple of tabs and the online platform will open. So when someone says 3 p.m. be very, very punctual. That is first thing. Second is just treat it as a normal interview. Dress how you will dress in a typical interview. And as far as the documents and everything are concerned, I think all the organizations, most of the organizations are accommodative enough to give in their that they can see the documents if the offer is finally rolled out. So no one is very tight about seeing the CVs or the documents. Anonymous, can you suggest some specific topics which can be covered through online courses pertaining to HR? Also, in your opinion, how important is getting certification for the same? I think certification today, even LinkedIn is giving, which is very funny, because certification doesn't require anything. So I personally feel that certification is not very important, because I've seen CVs when I'm interviewing mid-level HR managers. They have got some 10 to 12 different kind of certifications. So, and then I start asking questions to them about their certification, and to my surprise, they hardly know anything. So it's just a CV filling form, honestly. If you are convinced that you have learned stuff from that, I think that is more than enough for any course. Now, as far as the topic which is concerned, one topic which I have mentioned, I'll just re-mention it, is the Design Thinking and Employee Experience. There's a course on Udemy by Alan Cooper. And he is the founder of Cooper Associates, which is now owned by Wipro, of course. And this is one of the biggest design thinking firms in the world. And they've tried this example, which I have quoted, is what I also read about the pre-flight thing which Garima asked earlier. So you would be in a position to relate to that. It's a very cheap course, you can study that. At the same time, apart from any courses, my personal suggestion would be, if I am taking your interview, I would be looking as to how thorough you are with your past work, your internships, and the subject which you mentioned in the interview, if you are a fresher. Yeah. Okay. So Diksha is asking, sir, which HRIS are most trending now? Diksha, I would just like you to reframe the question as to in what terms you are asking HRIS. Okay. Trello, Asana. So are you looking for an HR software? If yes, it's a huge, huge market, honestly. It really depends. There are two big factors when it comes to HRIS software when we are deciding for any of our clients. The first thing is, what is the strength which is there in terms of manpower for any organization? And strength, more importantly, with the people who are white-collar, because typically blue-collar jobs don't really require HRIS software. That is more like payroll software. And the second thing which is there is about what are the functionalities the organization are looking for. So in HR, there are 80 odd functionalities. I cannot list all of them, but some of them which typically are used as performance management systems, the typical payroll attendance management systems, the leave management systems, and the ATS, which is the application tracking system. So these are the four important things which are there in plethora in the market. My personal suggestion, I don't want to be really biased about this thing, but if you have got any specific, now Asana, Trello, these are great platforms in itself, as you mentioned, but I don't want to be very biased about this thing. If you really have, you can drop me a LinkedIn message of any specific product which you're looking for. Okay. Kirti has asked me, as a fresher, what are certification course we can do to build our CV? Kirti, my personal suggestion would be that don't approach the CV building with the certification, because you're honestly inviting a lot of trouble if you have got a lot of certification, because the people who are sitting in front of you, obviously they are more experienced. So they would be in a position to dig deep, and let's say you're not able to answer questions from your course, or I mean they will not understand ki agar aapne kuch recruitment ke bare mein koi course kiya hai to recruitment ke around mein pucha hai, if not able to answer, they will not understand that aapke course mein kuch speech hai, because they are not any certified any B school type of course, they are not standardized things. So make sure you have got a couple of them, and things which you really are passionate about is what you should be going after in any kind of certification. Now Prashad has asked me, asking a specific set of questions to all candidates in an interview, is that how the HRs are trained as in the business, how they will answer whether a person is suitable or not? You mentioned about linking executive with desired job type. What are the activities I am related to your IT? So I think it's really difficult for me to understand that something cannot be related. I think anything can be related, and that is where your actual creativity is coming in. Now, if you feel that there is something which you cannot relate, and if you are able to do that, so I think you've already done enough to crack the interview. And as far as how HR are trained, I am not an HR trainer. I think it would be difficult for me to say the stuff. But my personal take definitely is that interviews aren't the best stuff to really evaluate the candidates, which we also at HeadsUp also, apart from interviews, we really focus on our summer internship or something. It's a very, very critical stage where it's all about evaluation for freshers. So we focus a lot on that. However, a lot of organizations have now adopted about psychometric testing, and also a lot of case-based testing in case study format. Now, should you be looking for anything specific, again, you can drop me a message on LinkedIn. We have got around 5 odd minutes, so I have to wait for it. Sorry. Rizul, your question would be answered through our blog. Do check our blog in next week. We are giving an exhaustive checklist of what to do on telephonic call and what to do on an online interview. Hopefully that will help. Another question is there, what is it that a fresher should do to make his or her candidates better than ours? Others? There's only one word which I say to everyone, to my employees every day, that be very creative and be very creative. That's it. There is no other substitute for this thing. I will never say something like a hard work or smart work. It's very difficult to quantify such thing. However, creativity, as much as being a subjective term, it can easily be quantified into how much impact that particular thing is creating in the business. So be very creative. Thank you. Sakshi Bansal has asked me, are there any issues that a company might face while virtually hiring candidates? Sakshi, my answer for this would be very that, see, this is something which is very new for everyone, for a candidate and also for the organization itself. Both of them, it's a new thing. So don't think or don't overthink about what will go wrong or right. It will be better that you just focus on whatever is the subject. Treat it as a normal interview. I think the thing will go perfectly. Thank you. Okay, another question which is there. After graduation, should we go for work experience and internship post-graduation? Go for post-graduation first and then start working. I think this is an age-old debate, honestly. I can only tell you about myself. I have never worked in any organization till now. I have been a fresher throughout. Even for my master's, I was a fresher and I just started off. So there is no answer for this question, honestly. I'm sorry, I will not be in a position to answer this. The last question which is there, we have 2 more minutes of any other questions where you can put in. that when is the right time to ask for constructive feedback and what would be a right medium to ask for it. I think a decent way about going for any constructive feedback, if you're already on the job, would be any weekly meetings. Whenever you are having any weekly meetings, that is a very good time. Times when you are in an informal setting, when I say informal setting, when you're sitting at lunch or right behind any having coffee, that is the time when you can all actually have these conversations, because both the set, like you and your supervisor or even your colleagues, your direct colleagues, are in a stage where they're not worked up. So they would be really chilled about saying stuff and not hiding anything. So I think time where things are very informal, that is the best time to take constructive feedback. Okay, so the last question is there. What can we do to ensure that employees are working to their full potential during work from home? Okay, working from home is something which is in itself a very important step in mankind. Honestly, no one expected something like this happening 1 month back. So to ensure some effectiveness, there are two important things which we are doing at Heads Up and which is personally working out great for us. I can only mention about that. The first thing is that update. Now, update is something which has to go from both the ends, not just the subordinates end, but also from the supervisor's end. Now, if it is not happening from both the channels, the engagement. Now, remote engagement is something which is so critical at this point of time, that typically you can do any kind of employee engagement surveys and things, and someone who has not filled it, you can go after him or her in the office and ask him to fill. But see, now if you have to really go about this remote engagement, you have to get yourself customized with what the other person is there in front of you. So an important thing for any person, whether you are a supervisor or a subordinate, that try to empathize a lot, because if someone who is staying at home doesn't mean that person will be working all the time. That is something which is very important. Give the person space if that is not happening, because in an office scenario also, if it's a typical 8 to 9 hour job which is there in any organization, no one works more than 4 or 5 hours. That's a fact which everyone really understands. And so you don't expect the person who is working from home to working for 8 or 9 hours, how it is there. Now, ghar se kaam kar raha to kaam hi kar lega. I think that attitude is something which will not be appreciated either by the subordinate or the supervisor. Don't overexpect. Over expectation is something which is bound for failure. You are going to fail. Don't do that. And as I said, always keep on giving each other update. I think work from home would work perfectly. So the last question which is there is, as you mentioned, creativity is subjective, but how to link it with your profile? It seems to be different from what I did earlier. Renuka has asked me that. Can you just reframe the question if that is okay with you? I'm not able to understand. Also, for all the people who are there as attendees, I'm just leaving my LinkedIn profile. You can, if you have any question, you can directly put a message. I would for sure reply in around 24 hours, and you can share it amongst your friends or colleagues. Also, I'm going to answer that. So, I think we're not getting anything. Any question, pause it for that. So, on this note, we are ending this webinar. I hope it was kind of enriching for all of you, and we will be back very soon, probably next week, about something related to what Heads Up or Heads Up vertical. Until that point of time, take care. Thank you.